Carlos Tanaka! Keep it going till he gets it!
Hi, I'm from Lithuania, and people often tell me that I always have a very serious expression on my face. And yeah, this is how you look when you spend 20 years in Eastern European maximum security prison. Which is the whole country. Anyway, I moved to UK because I love British culture. I love British people. I love British comedy. But mainly because I couldn't get a green card to the United States. And I have to admit, there are some small cultural differences between the UK and Eastern Europe. For example, the welfare system. In Eastern Europe, if you're unemployed, you get 100 euros a month and maybe some food assistance. In the UK, if a person has never worked a day in their life, not even a day, if they have contributed absolutely nothing to the budget or society, you give them millions of pounds, mansions, expensive cars, and call them royalty. Yeah, Buckingham Palace is actually my favorite social housing project. Beautifully done. Monarchy is weird, but I love living in London. I love living in London because it's the greatest city in the world. If you don't count New York or Los Angeles, maybe even Paris. Yeah, living in London is cool, but I think we can all agree that it has a massive drug problem. Delivery service is too slow. And sometimes people say to me that I should stop telling these jokes about the UK, but like, what's the worst that could happen? I get a free ticket to Rwanda? Would love to go there. It would be my first time. And you always remember your first time. I remember my first time drinking a beer. It was like 6. We start early in Eastern Europe. My first time smoking a cigarette, first time smoking weed, first time having sex. But I don't like to talk about that one, because I don't want my local priest to go to prison. Relax. I'm joking. Actually, it was Jimmy Savile. In all seriousness, I've never seen any of Jimmy Savile's content. Was it any good? We have a suspect in the room. Because at least when it comes to Michael Jackson, the guy made some good music. I'm not saying that it even swings out, but Thriller is an amazing album. Too bad that we had to sacrifice Macaulay Culkin for that. Well, I guess he wasn't home alone after all. That was my light material of the night. Anyway, my home country shares a border with Russia. And you can say whatever you want about Vladimir Putin. Yeah, he invaded Ukraine, he kills his opponents, he poisons journalists, whatever. But you have to admit, he would make a great employee. He has that whatever it takes mentality, that can-do attitude, and he has great commitment. If he starts a job, he won't leave the job for 20 years. And the thing about Vladimir Putin is that he does what he loves. Yeah, it's invading other countries and putting political dissidents in jail. But he does what he loves. And you can't choose what you love. And you have to remember, the guy's like 70 years old. He could have retired and spent his days playing golf. But no, he's still out there. Still hustling. Still making things happen. Still chasing his dream. Yeah, he's a war criminal. But he's also a go-getter. Like for the rest of the world, Ukraine is one of the main things right now. For Vladimir Putin, it's a side hustle. And speaking about hustling, because of the cost of living crisis, I got into the whole hustle hard motivational grindset culture. Started following a lot of these motivational influencers on TikTok and Twitter. So now I wake up every day at 5 in the morning, visualize success, write my affirmations. I plan to change my legal name to Bill Different. Middle name Savage. I don't run from challenges. I invite them into my life. So now I call British Gas every day and ask them to increase my utility bills. Because that will make me hustle harder. When I started doing comedy, I never thought that I would be making money from it and dating supermodels. Turns out, I was right. This set is brought to you by HelloFresh.co.uk. Go to HelloFresh.co.uk, enter the promo code the Cavendish Arms or something. I don't have a punchline for this joke. I was just walking here, listening to a podcast, heard an ad, thought, fuck it, I'll say it on stage. So thanks to HelloFresh for sponsoring the set.